Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you how to install and integrate Sysbox with Kasm Workspaces. Sysbox is an alternative to the Docker's default runc runtime that enhances the functionality of containers, making them behave more like virtual machines while maintaining security and isolation. By integrating Sysbox with Kasm Workspaces, you can achieve greater isolation, run software like systemd, Docker, etc. inside rootless containers without compromising security. Before we get started, let's go over the requirements to get this set up. You can refer to the official GitHub page of Sysbox to find the list of compatible operating systems. We recommend that you use a Ubuntu Jammy host with the 5.15 LTS kernel or newer. Based on your kernel version, you might have to manually install ShiftFS before installing Sysbox. If you already have an active installation of Kasm on your host, be aware that installing Sysbox may affect some of your existing containers. If you do not have an active installation of Kasm on your host, you can install Docker first, then Sysbox, and finally Kasm Workspaces. Docker can be installed using the install-dependencies.sh script that comes pre-bundled with the Kasm installer. In this video, I already have Kasm Workspaces installed on my machine. First, you can find out your kernel version with this command. My version is 5.18, so let me install ShiftFS manually first. You can skip this step if your kernel version is 6.5 LTS or newer. To install ShiftFS, follow these steps. First, update and install necessary packages. You can refer to the description to find all the commands that I'm executing in this video. Next, clone the ShiftFS DKMS repository and install ShiftFS. Once ShiftFS is installed, verify the installation with this command. You should now see output similar to this. This means that ShiftFS is successfully installed on your host. You can now reboot your machine to complete the setup. Next, we'll install Sysbox. After your machine reboots, continue with the following commands. First, install jq and wget. Next, download and install Sysbox. If you get an error like this, it is probably because you have active Docker containers on your machine. You need to stop and remove all the Docker containers first. You can do so with this command. This command will remove both the running and stopped containers on your host, including those managed by Kasm. So proceed with caution. Now that all the containers have been removed, I can install Sysbox without any error. Finally, once Sysbox is installed, you can verify the Docker daemon configuration to see if Sysbox is installed and configured correctly. Also, you can now go ahead and start Kasm again with this command. Alright, now let's configure Kasm Workspaces to use Sysbox runtime. This requires modifying the Docker run configuration. Log into your Kasm Workspaces admin panel and navigate to Admin, Workspaces, Workspaces, select the image you want to configure and click Edit. Scroll down to Docker run config override JSON and paste the following configuration to use Sysbox for this particular workspace. This can also be set at a group level under Access Management, Groups, select the group that you want to configure and click Edit. Go to Settings, click on Add Setting, and then select Run Config from the drop-down menu, and finally paste the same JSON configuration. In order to be able to use root inside the workspace, you also need to install and configure sudo. Go to Workspaces again, select the workspace you want to configure and click Edit. Now scroll down to Docker exec config and paste this configuration. With Sysbox integrated with Kasm Workspaces, let me demonstrate some of the benefits. Let me show you how workspaces can now support running Docker inside them while maintaining isolation. Let me first install Docker in my Sysbox enabled workspace. I will first switch to root user with sudo. Now I will run these commands as root to install Docker on my Ubuntu workspace. As you can see, I have Docker installed in my workspace and it is running. Let me now run a container inside my workspace to demonstrate that Docker in Docker is made possible with Sysbox on rootless containers. As you can see, I am now able to run a Docker container inside my current workspace with the help of Sysbox. That will be all for today's tutorial on integrating Sysbox with Kasm Workspaces. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.